The Rock of Salvation, 107.1 KOUJ LP, Norman, Oklahoma.
KUJ 107.1 FM, KJ.org. It is the Rock of Salvation. And that was a little bit of that X Center peer pressure for you there. And right now, I am so super stoked and excited talking about the one, the only. I get to talk to my boys. This is the protest going to the phone lines. Who am I speaking with?
This is Josh. What's up, dude?
What's going on, Josh?
Hey, living the dream. It's a beautiful day here in central Indiana.
All right, rocking out Indiana, and we're here in Norman, Oklahoma. First of all, before we go any further, just let me say that you guys are my absolute favorite band out right now. You have the
Thank
most
so
coolest
much,
music out there. And so stinking awesome in concert. For all the people who has not seen the protest, you have to go see them live. They put on one of the most amazing shows ever.
Wow, that is extremely kind. Can you say that again so I can record it and, you know, play it for my wife at least?
We're actually recording it for you. I can send it to you.
Oh, okay. Good, good, good. No, seriously, man. Thank you for your kind words. We really try to give it all we got out there on stage. You know, we love making music and writing music and recording, but, you know, live is where we thrive.
Yeah, you guys are just phenomenal. From the moment you sit on stage till you get off, it's a all-out freak show for sure. See, I threw that in there, by the way.
Thank you so much. Yeah, I love that.
Yeah. So let's talk about the protests and some of these things you got. You're just coming off the City Rock Fest tour. And,
yes, sir.
And give us a few highlights on the tour that you just came off of.
Oh, man. It was an absolute blast. We've... You know, going out on City Rock Fest is kind of like going to a family reunion. You know what I mean? Except it's not awkward and there's not tons of potato salad usually. But no, man, like every band we just love. And I think for me it was really cool touring with Righteous Vendetta. We've been friends with those guys for a while, but have yet to do a run with them. So getting to spend time with them was really cool. You know, I think. As far as highlights go, man, we had some really, really good shows, some special nights, some people that gave their life to the Lord. I know personally, one of the coolest things for me, when we had some days off in New Mexico, we were staying with a wonderful family there. Me and the guys went to a place called Tent Rock and got to hike and climb and look for rattlesnakes and scorpions and all that good stuff. And we made it out alive. So, you know, that was really cool. And then probably one of the coolest things for me, and the guys, but you know, me as a big brother was, my brother played a few shows with Skillet, on, the last couple months. And, we got to go, on one of our days off on the road and actually see him play, in a big arena with Skillet and Breaking Benjamin. And it was just a really, really cool experience. I was such a proud big brother. I was having a hard time not grabbing everyone's shoulder that I didn't know and say, hey, that's my brother, you know what I mean?
Right.
But I'm super proud of him, and that was just a really cool experience, and I know he was very humbled to do that. So
yeah, that had to be pretty shocking to have Skillet call you up and say, hey man, we know you guys are out on tour, but can we steal your drummer for a little while? How did that actually happen when you're out on tour?
Well, yeah, so you know, God is so good, man, and you know, he knows what we need and he just takes care of us. You know, we last winter we did a run and we had a couple shows with John Cooper's other band, Fight the Fury. They're just really good guys, and we hit it off. We exchanged information, you know, and a couple weeks later, they hit Jerb up and say, hey, you know, this spring, you know, we're in need of a fill-in because Jen will be doing some dates that conflict. And, yeah, and I think, you know, for me, TJ, and Adam, it was kind of a unanimous thing, you know. I mean, we love my brother and we want him to experience this, and you know, so we said yes. And then Blaze from Seventh Day Slumber was gracious enough to fill in Jarrett's stead for the shows that he missed and did an absolute amazing job.
Yeah, it was great to see Blaze back there, and he did a great job. But man, you know, as soon as I seen that your brother was going to be with Skillet, that was my first thought. It was like, well, are they going to do a three-piece, or how are they going to do this? You know, so.
you'd be very disappointed with a protest three-piece, probably.
So. I was like, who's going to do drums?
No, Blaze is such an amazing drummer and such an amazing kid. I always forget he's so young because the way he carries himself, mm-hmm. and he's so professional. And I knew when Blaze said that he could play for us, my heart was at ease because he's an absolute pro.
He is. He's awesome. You know, my little boy, he's 7 years old, and he is a protest fanatic.
He's just,
he's been trying to teach himself how to play drums and stuff, and he loves Welcome to the Freak Show, and he plays it all the time. And they were actually having a deal at Guitar Center a couple weeks ago, and he hasn't been old enough for them to teach. So they were having a free day. Come sit in. I was like, well, he really wants to. And so he sat in with the drummer, and the guy goes, well, who's your favorite band? He goes, The Protest. He goes, what's your favorite song? He goes, Welcome to the Freak Show. And that guy goes, huh? He's looking at Levi, you know, this little kid. He goes, Welcome to the Freak Show. I said, yeah, it's a Christian rock band. They're really, really good. He goes, he looks at Levi, and he goes, you like metal? He's like, yeah, I don't play slow songs. He goes, only fast songs. And he goes, well, I'm going to have to check out this band, The Protest, then. He goes, yeah, they do a lot of... And it was so funny. I'm sitting there trying to keep him laughing because, you know, Levi had just turned 7 and he's acting like an adult. He goes, yeah, it's a lot of double kick bass. You got to make sure you do a lot of double kick bass when you played The Protest.
I love that. He was at the show down there, right?
Yes.
He's a really well-behaved kid.
Yeah, that's
I was very surprised. He carries himself very well, you know?
Oh, he gets locked into them rock shows. He's all about.
I love it.
You know, he won't even let it. Like, he don't want to be by stage. He wants to be up where he can see and everything and watch the drummer.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so
that's
cool.
Yeah, very cool, man.
He definitely loved him some Protest that night for sure.
Good. Well, I'm glad to hear that there's a new generation of Christian rockers coming up down there.
Oh yeah,
hold down the fort for us when us old guys have to quit.
You better believe it. So talking about the guys, are you starting out on a little summer tour yourself? And so talk about some of the places you're trying to hit up. I know there's some people trying to work on a show here in Oklahoma. Have you finalized anything? Or
we're getting really close. I actually, I've been speaking. So years ago, we played in OKC with the Cypher Down, and I've been speaking with an organization there pretty recently, and things are sounding pretty good. So, you know, pray and cross your fingers. But I think we're going to end up having a date close by this July. So, yeah, this summer we're starting to get some festival dates coming in, and, you know, we're just going to book some shows around those. You know, we have Life Fest up in Oshkosh. So I think Protest fans can expect some, you know, Midwest shows. We have Kingdom Come Fest next month, which is our favorite.
Yeah,
one of our favorite shows of the whole year.
That
it's
would
a really
be so
cool show.
Cool. Yeah.
Oh yeah, it's one of the best festivals out there, man. It's totally free, and they have some of the best talent coming from all over the country, and it's just some of the best staff. We love it. After that, we've got Chains on Chain Fest and some dates in between that, and then Uprise Fest coming up around the bend, and back to Germany in the fall. So, yeah.
Yeah, definitely sounds like it's that time of year to start hitting the festivals and stuff. We got the block party coming up here. We're new, trying to start our own little festival here in Oklahoma. And I was telling
you guys have Spoken, right?
Yeah, Spoken's going to be headlining it this year.
Good.
And I was telling Doc, I was like, you know, I said, I'm not going to be happy until the Protest plays the block party. So,
hey,
so I'm trying.
Keep us in mind. We'd love that.
I said, so next year, I told him, I said, we got to have the Protest headline our block party.
I love it.
I said, it's June 1st, so you can go ahead and mark that date off for next year.
Okay.
And just build your tour around it. Because,
got it.
Because
okay.
Next year, I'm with the Protest to headline the block party.
Okay.
So we already made that. We got that contract already down.
Hey, man, send it my way.
Okay. Yeah, love the protest. So as we get ready, I'm fixing to play us. You know what song I'm going to play to start off?
Oh, yeah. You got to.
Yeah, and then we'll go into, you know, your new stuff. But there's no way I can't do a interview without you guys, without playing this song. And to my little boys listening at home, this is the protest. Welcome to the Freak Show on KOJ1071, KOJ.org. J1071 FM, KJ.org. Welcome to the Freak Show, The Protest. Man, guys, I love that song and the whole album. That is probably one of the best albums I've heard in a decade. It is, I just love that album.
Thank you so much. And thank you so much.
It's just from start to finish, it is such a, there's rare that you get those albums that you listen to every song. You know, sometimes you just like pick and choose what songs you want to hear. And that album there is just phenomenal. It's like,
well, thank you. Thank you so much.
There's not a bad song in it. And I love Haunted House. That's another.
Well, we really explored, Mark Anthony from The Letter Black did that record for us. And he's an awesome songwriter. And we just really kind of had fun and explored, and you know, there's a lot of tongue-in-cheek kind of stuff on that record, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But you know, we just really wanted a cool hard rock record that was different, you know what I mean, with songs that were different and right. Epic, and you know, and above all, reach people. So you know, we're very happy with that record, and yeah, it's awesome.
And, you know, we're talking about that, and that is their old album. They actually got a brand new album out now that is just as impactful, just as powerful, and it's actually on our top 10. You know, we're going to play Noise Revolution here in a little bit, which I don't know if you just listened to the top 10 countdown a little earlier, but you guys was on our top 10 countdown as number All seven right. for Noise Revolution. Still on Love the countdown, it. Not better yet, you know, with that song. But before we get into playing that, I want to talk to you guys about your faith and when was your Jesus moment, not only in your life, but also like going on tour, and when did you know that this was the moment in time that God, you definitely knew that's when he sent you out on the road and that one person that came up and spoke to you?
Sure. So I think personally, for me, you know, my story is, you know, one might say it's, you know, I think from an outside perspective, it may sound boring because I, you know, I was blessed to be raised in a Christian home, and I was blessed, you know, I wasn't addicted to drugs. I wasn't, you know, so my faith story is a kind of an interesting one. You know, I was raised in a Christian home with amazing parents, and I went to church every Sunday, but problem was I didn't really understand. I never understood what it meant to have a relationship with Jesus. So, you know, even in middle school and high school, and I was playing in the praise band, I'm going to all these church events and having a good time, I never really had that heart connection with Jesus. You know, I thought, you know, rather naively that, you know, my mom was really active in the church and, you know, her relationship's so good with Jesus. You know, I thought that kind of covered me, if you know what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. So really, man, I went to college, right after high school, and I was in the band at the time, but you know, I thought that that's what you had to do. I thought that you're supposed to go to college. I thought that you had to get a business degree because that's what everyone else was doing. And I got nervous and I was afraid to follow my dream because, you know, ministry's scary. So I was at college and I was miserable. I was not where I was supposed to be. And I was walking across campus one day and I just broke down and started crying. I had become extremely nervous, extremely anxious, extremely depressed. And I didn't know how to handle it anymore. And I was walking across campus on my way to class. And in my head, I stopped and I started crying, weeping. And I ran over to a bench to kind of hide from, you know, folks. And I prayed, I cried out to Jesus and asked for his help and asked for his saving grace. And, a couple of days later, I made the decision to, drop out of school, which, you know, I think in the world's eyes is a kind of a dumb decision, but I, you know, there was no doubt about it for me. I was, you know, I think school's great but at the time it just wasn't for me. And after that, I prayed for God's will, and the band was what God wanted for me. And that's what I've been doing ever since. And you know, in all of our touring experiences, and God has just shown up in just unbelievable ways. I think one story that, just shows you the power of God working through people. I'll try to condense it. A couple years ago, we're on tour. We're in North Carolina, and our bus starts breaking down about 10 miles from the venue. We limp it in just barely. But after that, the bus was pretty much toast. We needed a new transmission, lots of money. We were stuck. So this family took us in. They let us stay at their house for like a week, and we kept trying to get our bus fixed, but like no one could do it fast enough. And, you know, we finally found someone that would, but like the enemy was just attacking because the parts wouldn't come in on time, or they put a part in, but it wasn't the right part. And it was just so frustrating. And I remember just being such a wreck because we were going to have to miss some shows or cancel the tour. And, you know, we never want to do that, you know? So fast forward a little bit. We send all of our gear with the other band we're touring with and say, hey, we'll try to meet you guys down there. Our bus wasn't done in time, so we were stuck, and we were prepared to cancel shows. But the family that we were staying with said, hey, hop in our cars. We're going to drive you 6 hours south through the night to meet up with the other band. So this family selflessly drove us all the way down the down to Georgia overnight. When we got there, we realized that all of our stuff and ourselves wouldn't fit with the other band. So we're kind of stuck again, and this family says, you know what? Take our minivan. Just take it. Take it across the country. Finish your tour. So this family gave us their minivan to finish this tour. And we didn't know them but for that 1 week. And, you know, like, these people just love Jesus and wanted to see lives changed. So they did that, and the darndest thing happened. 2 weeks later, their van breaks down. And we're like, oh, my gosh. So we just ruined these folks' van, and we call him, and he just starts dying laughing and said, hey, when the record comes, just tell him he can keep it. So, and then someone from the venue drove 3 hours just to pick us up so we could make the show. And then we found a rental, and everything worked out. So, you know, to make a long story short, like, that kind of stuff happens all the time. I think the world thinks there's so many bad people out there, and everything's bad, and everyone's in it for themselves and hateful and this and that. But, man, being in a band and traveling the country and meeting all these amazing people, there is just so many folks out there that love Jesus so much, they're willing to literally do anything for you. And I ask any band out there that's doing ministry, they have similar stories. I guarantee it. People that house you, feed you, give you money, take you out for dinner, buy you hotel rooms, you know, just take care of you. It's an honor, man.
That is so awesome, because, you know, that's the thing, though, and none of that happens without obedience. If you guys didn't say, you know, I'm leaving this totally up to God, I'm stepping totally out on his faith, you know, that I'm going to hit the road and he's going to protect us and guide us the whole way through. Because there's a lot of times in situations like that, we give up. We're like, you get hit in the face with some strife or whatever, and we're like, I can't do this anymore. I got to stop. Yep. I made a bad decision.
And you're totally right, man. I mean, like, I was so stressed out and worried. Like, I mean, at the time, I'm in my mid-20s, and I called my dad and was like crying on the phone. I was so stressed out, and, like, you know, I got so worked up and worked up, but all these things have built my faith, has built the band's faith. You know, like, we know that God has us now. We don't know how or, you know, how things are going to work out sometimes, but, you know, God moves, man, and it's a beautiful thing to see it work.
Yeah, and the cool thing is those stories like that, they become testimonies about how God, how good God is, that you can tell at a later point in time. I think some of the best sermons ever are somebody's testimony, because people going out there and just go through the same things, and just when somebody's about to give up on life, you tell them a story like that right there, and they're like, oh, man, it's so awesome.
Yeah.
You know?
Dude, hey, amen. I mean, it's one of the things where, you know, like, you know, people that don't know Jesus, you know, you can read scripture to them all you want, but they may not believe it. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But something they can't take away is your personal testimony. You know, they can't say, hey, that's not real. That didn't happen to you. You know what I mean? So
exactly.
I think it's a great way to kind of make a wedge in there, open their hearts, and then you can bring in, you know, the scripture and the teachings. But, you know, I think you're totally right, man. I mean, personal testimony is huge.
Yeah, because sometimes we're the only Jesus somebody's ever going to see. They won't step foot in a church, but they'll come and see the protest and concert. You know,
And there's so much gravity to that situation. You know, there's some days, man, where I'm just kind of in a bad mood and I'm down in the dumps, and, you know, I show up to the venue and I just don't really feel like, you know, talking to anybody. I feel like being in my own little cloud, and, you know, but, you know, I think you hit the nail on the head. You know, at all times, you know, we as Christians, all of us, you know, we could be Jesus for that person.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
At any time, even at a gas station. You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't matter where, you know? So I'm glad you said that, because that's so true.
Yeah, you know, and there's in the same sense, there's been those times to you, you know, you're like, man, I so wish I would have handled that a different way. You know, I failed in such a major way, because it's like, you know, there's times, you know, like, especially when people's like, you know, even at my job at the airport or whatever, you know, and I'll do something, I'm like, man, that was so wrong. I should have done it this way. Because everybody looks at you, oh, there's the preacher. That said, said there's the Christian over there. It's like, hey, still human. I still, you know, there's those anger issues that come out sometime. But I think you're right. You know, we're put on such a, especially a band like The Protest or KUJ, you're not representing just the music, but you're representing God in everything you do. And, you know, it's like, so we have to be on alert sometimes because people are waiting to see how we react to certain situations. And that's one of the things I love about, you know, going, like, I seen you guys, and right when I walked into the venue a couple months ago, you were standing there and talking to a couple of people from the radio station stuff and just hanging out, being cool. And that right there alone speaks volumes, because, you know, when people go to shows, they see the people on stage. But what's the impact is the lasting connection you have with somebody. So it's so awesome that, you know, like I said, you can be there and you're like, hey, I'm going to this concert. Would you like to go with me? And that person may never, ever, like I said, step in a church, but they go to a concert like that. And I've done that many a times to where I've had people from my job at the airport actually go to concerts just to see a band. Cool, and there's been times where those same people I work with gave their life to Christ at a rock show, and they wouldn't even step into a church before that. So,
and that, my friend, is what it's all about.
and that's the power of it, especially with Christian rock, because with the world and the church, it's still so hard for Christian rock to make it these days. It's like on both sides of the coin. You're trying to get into churches, and you know, and then you're trying to get into the other shows as well, and you're just being labeled in both places, opposite.
Yeah. It's tough, man. It is tough. You know, I think, you know, me and some of the guys from the station talked about that. And, you know, what I always come down to, yes, it's true that, you know, Christian rock is, you know, some say it's struggling. I see tons of amazing, hardworking bands that don't have a lot of money or a lot of representation, but they're out there killing it because they love Jesus. You know what I mean? And I'm not just saying this, like, some of the best bands out there are Christian rock bands, and I'm not, I mean, that's unbiased, I promise. Like, I mean, there's some great hard rock bands. I like some secular music, I do, and there's some really good hard rock and metal bands out there, but take Disciple, for example. Like, in my mind, secular or Christian, whatever, rock period, I don't think there's a better band or show than that. You know what I mean?
And I do.
And I really think Christian rock is rising, and I think it's still being kept alive, and, you know, when it all comes down to it, it's this, you know, we're not just in the Christian rock business, because, you know, business can fail, but, you know, we're in God's business, and God's business never fails. So, you know, whenever there's people that love hard music and still need to be reached by the gospel, then, you know, we're going to fill that void and fill that niche. And, You know, we don't want to just stop at churches. We want to play churches. We want to play bars. We want to play clubs. And that's what we do, because everybody needs Jesus. People at church need Jesus. People at the bars need Jesus. I need Jesus. You know what I mean?
The music industry may fail us, but God never will. And that's the thing about it. And, you know, you hit a point a while ago that I thought was so cool, is that you were talking about hitting the bar scenes and stuff, and the secular vision of the world and stuff. But you was talking about how we were talking about the Christian rock. And the one thing that I've been telling Doc since I got back into radio a little over a year ago, it was a year in February. I did radio for many, many years. I was putting on all the concerts here in Oklahoma and stuff. And I just got away from it because it seemed like the bands wasn't really showing love and Christian the way I thought they should be and stuff. And it just, I got so burnt out on it. And this last year and a half of being back in radio, I said, we are in a rock revival. I've never in the whole years of me doing Christian radio have seen so many bands on fire for God and doing it for the right reason. So I think when people say Christian rock is on a downflow, I'm with you saying it's on a rise right now, because I think what has happened is a lot of the bands that wasn't doing it for the right reasons have been weeded out, and all the bands that are on fire for God has put this revival going on from state to state. And I think that's why I said we're in a rock revival right now, and you can tell the difference on the songs and the talent. And it, and overall, it's just been an upgrade to what used to be out there. And you're right. The music being put out right now can be played on any radio station out there, secular or not. And the crossover is the is so amazing. And what's crazy is there'll be people at my job and stuff I was talking about, and they'll hear a song or they'll be playing a song and they know the words to it. And I'm like, hey, you know it's a Christian band, don't you? And they're like, what? They just know the songs and stuff now. They don't even realize, you know, until they start listening to words. And, you know, they're getting this message putting into them that, you know, that, like I said, they're realizing that, you know, hey, they're getting the word. They're getting positive message sent to them. And it's crossing over now. A lot of the secular stations are playing a lot of the bands, you know, especially with, like, Rockfest Records out there that, you know, it's just everything is upgraded to me, it seems like. And it's all because it's God first.
Amen. Yep. And I think, you know, if you put God first, then, you know, like, there will be success. And, you know, and success is a very interesting term because, you know, if we're going by money standards, then, you know, a lot of Christian rock bands are not, you know what I mean? But if you're going by, you know, the will to reach people with the gospel and, you know, then, and the fact that all these bands out there, our friends are out there with us, you know, changing lives, you know, we're co-laborers, you know, like your radio station's changing lives, you know, that is a success. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Oh yeah.
And God takes care of us, man. I mean, we don't have a lot, but God always takes care of us and we have what we need, you know?
Oh, 100%. That was a message today in church, actually. It was about, you know, about how rich are you? A lot of people think you're rich by possessions, but you're actually rich in your surroundings. You know, it's not the possessions, but it's the people in your life. It's the ministry you get to do. It's the impact you're having on other people. You know, I had a kid in youth group not so long ago. It was like, asked me, are you rich? I said, I'm the richest person I know. It's like, really, how much money you got and stuff? And I was like, oh no, I'm not talking about money wise. I said that I get to do youth ministry every Wednesday night with you guys. And having my family stuff makes me the richest guy on the planet. I said, you guys, and I said, and not to mention Sunday nights, I said, I'm on the radio and I get to hang out and talk with bands. I said, my life, I said, I feel like I'm the richest guy on the planet. I said, God has blessed me with so much. I may not have money and the big house or anything. I said, but I got the life that I've always wanted. I said, you know, I'm hanging with rock bands and doing youth ministry. I mean, how much more can I get out of life than that? You know,
it's like,
I got the amazing little family. I got the son that's a future rock star. And I said, I said, the value in life is not the bank. The value in life is the legacy you live.
Yes. Big time. And that's why we named our album that. So it's like full circle. Right.
There you go. All right. How about let's play some new music?
Sure. Sounds good.
All right. This is The Protest with Noise Revolution on KUJ 1071, KUJ.org.
Tonight, tonight, everybody turn it up. We rise, we fight. We rise, we fight.
KUJ 107.1 FM, KJ.org, the protest noise revolution, back-to-back super mega albums. It is protest. I love both of these albums, two of the baddest albums out there for sure. And
thank you.
And I'm telling you, people, you have to get this. And, you know, we just seen you at City Rock Fest not too long ago, and there was a couple there from my church that became super fans that night as well. I seen them at
very
church.
Cool.
You know, they were actually up there on the front row. They bought the VIP. And
yeah.
So when I got to see them again at church, I was like, so who stole the show? I said, first of all, that was a show of headliners. I said,
oh, yeah.
You know, usually you go to a show, you got a headliner and some openers. I said, that was a show
yeah.
of headliners. Every band that night
yeah.
was a headliner. And
I said, who
was the band that stood out to you? And they were like, the Protest. And I was like, yep, that's my boy. I said, those guys are phenomenal.
And that's
not taking anything away from any other band that was there tonight, because like I said, that was a headliner night. Every band there was over the top.
Oh, yeah. Some of the best talent in the country on that tour.
There was. I mean, I became another one of the bands that stuck out to me that night was Random Hero. I was a fan of their music, but that's the first time I seen them live.
Live, that's a whole different bird. Like, I mean, they have great music and stuff, but again, you know, they're one of those bands that awesome live, super good to see live. So.
Yeah, and I had no clue because I just listened to their music a lot, you know, and that's what you people out there, if you don't go to concerts, you're missing out, because it's one thing to listen to these guys' music, but when you go see them live, it's a whole nother show. You know, so, and I was telling Doc, I was like, yeah, we got to get the Protest. I said, my dream show right now would be, and I said, we get 2-for-1 deal on this deal too. I said, Random Heroes on and Protest.
Yeah.
I was like, that's a tour.
Enough.
That's a tour y'all should think about. That would be
definitely.
That would be amazing. But I'm talking to the Protest. This is Josh, and man, dude, thank you so much for coming on the show tonight. And this is one of those nights where I don't really feel like I'm being a DJ at a radio station, but I get to be a fan, hang out, and these are my favorite kind of interviews right here.
Well, man, it's been an honor. You know, we talked a little bit while one of our songs was playing, but I truly mean it, man. I appreciate your guys' station. I appreciate you guys supporting what we do and what my friends do. And, you know, we couldn't do it without you guys, and we're on the same team, and I absolutely love that. So thank you for your time and support.
And, dude, I hope, and I'm praying that show comes to Oklahoma City or anywhere around here close, because I would definitely be at that show.
All right.
There's no way I could be a good dad and not take my little boy to see you guys if you're anywhere around here.
Well, knowing that he's such a big fan, remind me, we'll do something special for him. He can come hang out with us backstage, or, you know, something like that. He can hang out with Jarob and maybe even let him play on his kid a little bit or something.
Oh, he would. I'd fall out and pass out. I see my little boy on that. No. That is so cool. Definitely. Man, hey, Josh, before we go, is it okay if I pray with you?
I would love that.
Father God, we thank you so much for the Protest and just their obedience to go out there on the road and to spread the gospel, Father God. And I pray as they're getting ready for this summer concert tour and festivals that they're at, Father, that you just put a hedge of protection around them, Father, and just be there and be with them as they're on the road, Father. Never let them grow weary, Father, and just give them strength every day. And, Father, we're praying for that brand-new album, not the one that just came out, but for the one you got coming that you're putting in their heads right now that'll be out in a few years, Father God. We're already planting the seeds for the next album that you got for them, Father, that you just keep that every stroke of the pen is down is from you, Father God, and that they keep with their talent and keep following you in everything they do. Father, we give all this unto you, and in your precious name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Josh, so much again, and it is such an honor. Anytime you got anything going on that you need us to support, or when you're ready to release a new single, just hit me up or whatever, and it'll automatically go straight into rotation.
Well, I've heard from the higher-ups that there's one more single left on the record we're going to start pushing. So I don't know when that'll be, but you'll definitely get it, and I'd love for you guys to spin it.
Oh, we definitely will. Well, matter of fact, we'll probably call you up and let you debut it on here.
Yeah. Hey, I would love that.
All righty, Josh. You have a good night, buddy, and look forward to hanging out with you.
All right, man. Be blessed. Take care.
You too.
Man, 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 be blessed. Take care.
You too.